decisions.
A lot of support.
Need to confer just one minute. Okay. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sheriff Sam Page, Sheriff of Rockingham County, North Carolina. I'd like to welcome all of our special guests that are here today for this news conference on our basically phase one pushout of the Volunteer School Safety Resource Officer Program, piece of legislation that was enacted in 2013 that we're pulling up as a tool to try to utilize in Rockingham County, North Carolina, and maybe across the state of North Carolina. At this time, I'd like to introduce some of our guests that are here today. Today we have North Carolina President Pro Tempore, Senator Phil Berger, North Carolina Speaker of the House, Tim Moore, Representative Kyle Hall, Representative Burt Jones, unavailable today, had a doctor's appointment, Chairman of the Rockingham County Commissioners, Kevin Berger, Rockingham County Manager, Lance Metzler, in the back, Dr. Rodney Shotwell, Rockingham County School Superintendent, and also I know we have some representatives of the school board that are here. Thank you for being here today. City managers from Eden, Reesville, Madison, Mayodan, Stonewall, and Wentworth. Thank you. We also have some police chiefs present. If you're a police chief here present, would you give your name and the city that you work in?
Charles Crusoe, Mayodan.
Mike Rutherford, Madison.
Chief Hassel, Reesville.
And Chief Frank Moore was tied up, but couldn't be here, but he sends his regards and regrets. How about sheriffs that are present here today besides myself? Yeah. Please, sheriffs.
Sheriff Robert Graves, Randolph County.
Sheriff Charles McDonald, Henderson County.
Sheriff Tony Durden, Caswell County.
And again, welcome to you also. And also, I'd like to thank the Rockingham County Sheriff's Office staff that helped set up the room and also helped make this event possible today. Well, the question you ask is, why are we here today? Well, in law enforcement and protecting our schools, we have three concerns. Our job is to protect and serve the students, the teachers, the principals, and protect our schools. Teachers want to teach, children want to learn. That's our goal, to make sure that happens. We're here today to show our support for school safety in North Carolina and protecting our children and their teachers. I'm a parent of a grown child. I was her resource officer, and I've served in law enforcement for more than 30 years. I'm tired of seeing all the school violence and shootings in this country. These type of incidents could happen anywhere, as we know, anytime, and you can't predict an event, but we can prepare for these types of scenarios. We need to target harden our schools. You've heard it on TV. Schools are looked at as soft targets, but we need to do something to better protect our kids, and we need to do it now. The time for action is now. We saw what happened in Stoneman Douglas High School in Florida just recently, a mass shooting. Sandy Hook Elementary School in Connecticut in 2012, a mass shooting. Columbine High School in 1999. So basically, ever since I've been the sheriff of Rockingham County, I've seen these events happen around the country, and I look at what can we do to better protect our schools, working with our school officials, working with our principals, working with our school resource officers. Enough is enough today in North Carolina. Taking no action towards school safety and not protecting our teachers and children is totally unacceptable. That's why we're all here today, to show our support that we want to take action. Now, I'm going to give you an overview of the law. You probably read a recent pushout we did last week. I met with Dr. Shotwell, had a good conversation. looked at the possibility of enacting this program. But in 2013, following the Sandy Hook shooting, our North Carolina legislature was able to pass a law to allow for experienced, sworn law enforcement officers and former military police to participate in a volunteer school safety resource officer program. I want to repeat, experienced, sworn law enforcement officers and military police to participate in a volunteer safety school resource officer program. With a minimum of 2 years experience, honorable discharge, pass a physical, meet sheriff's or criminal justice standards for education and firearm proficiency. Agreements with our local school boards to allow program to participate, and under the supervision, the school resource officers, volunteers, would be under the supervision of a sheriff or chief or their designee within the agency. The volunteer has the power of arrest while carrying out their duties, and there are no liabilities while serving as a volunteer while they're acting in good faith carrying out their duties. Now, this bill was passed by our legislature in 2013. But now, in 2018, we can't wait for another tragic event and loss of even one child's life. I brought this 2013 law and content to the attention of my superintendent, Dr. Shotwell, Rodney Shotwell, who is with us on the podium today. And recently, as one possible solution, I didn't say the total solution, but one possible solution, and it's already there in the law. With Dr. Shotwell's approval, I moved forward with this project, and I contacted our local chiefs and some sheriffs around North Carolina to consider this volunteer program as just one possibility for school safety in our county and in North Carolina. If we're successful, we have the opportunity to establish a model and a template for the rest of North Carolina to follow, so other school districts can protect their schools and children. No other school district, and I'm aware of it, North Carolina is involved in this program yet, and I hope to see more involved. Is this program the total solution? No, I just see this as one tool in our toolbox provided to help law enforcement in our counties to supplement school safety coverage. A full-time paid school resource officer in each school in our county would be another option. The funding and adding of school counselors and school psychologists would also be a welcome addition. Some of these options are good, but a combination would be better. What is sad is that we can protect our airports, professional sporting events, and all kinds of dignitaries in the land with armed protection, but we don't seem to be able to spend enough money in America to protect our most precious little ones in school and their teachers. With this continued support of our legislature and its leadership, we can make a difference in school safety. We must do better, and we can do better. Thank you. At this time, I'd like to call up Senator Phil Berger for a few words.
Thank you, Sheriff. I'm here because I wanted to commend Sheriff Page and also the other sheriffs, local school board, local authorities for their willingness to look at this law that that was passed a couple of years ago. I think this is the right step to take, one of many that likely will need to be taken, and I certainly appreciate the sheriff's proactive stance on this. I also wanted to introduce Senator Ron Raven. Senator Raven is the co-chair of the Joint Legislative Committee on Emergency Management, and that is a committee that has been looking into some of these issues dealing with schools and school violence over the past several months, and actually over the past several years. So he came here from Harnett County, represents Harnett, Lee, and Johnson County, and I appreciate Senator Raven, who's also a retired military officer who has a great interest in doing everything that that he can to help the legislature understand some of these issues. So thank you very much, and Sheriff, thank you.
Thank you. At this time, I'd like to have Speaker Moore, if you'd like to come up and say a few words, and we appreciate you being here today.
Thank you, Sheriff Page. Also, I want to recognize my colleague, Kyle Hall, who's doing a fantastic job for this county and the legislature, and who has supported this legislation. You know, the Volunteer Resource Officer Program, I think, has been aptly described as another piece of the puzzle. It's one more piece to make our schools safer. As a parent of two young boys who were in the public schools in my home county, I'm like every other parent, I want the best protection for every child in school. I applaud, Sheriff, what you are doing here and what the other sheriffs are doing around the state to take advantage of this law that was passed in 2013. And also know that our, we know that our work isn't done. We presently are working in the House of the Select Committee, and the Senate, of course, has an Oversight Committee as well that has looked, that both committees are looking at these issues. We know it's not one thing. We know it takes a combination of their mental health issues, it's criminal justice, it's hardening the targets and you know, hardening the schools and making them safer from shooters. It's a combination of approaches that are going to be necessary to make sure that our students are as safe as they can be. But I'm here today in Senator Berger and Representative Paul's district to voice my support for what police chiefs and the sheriffs and the law enforcement community are doing, and certainly in taking advantage of this law that we're very proud that we have. Matter of fact, we're probably ahead of the curve, I would say, in North Carolina in even having this law on the books. Something that we already have now is something that other states are talking about implementing. So, thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you, Sheriff, and thank you all for being here. I have the honor of representing part of Rockingham County in the North Carolina House, as Speaker Moore mentioned. And I was not around when the bill was passed, but I do support what Sheriff Page is doing. The most vital resource that the state of North Carolina has is in each and every classroom in the state of North Carolina. We've got to do everything that we can to make sure that they are protected each and every day that they go into that school, and also our teachers to make sure that they are protected. And I am so glad that not only has Sheriff Page and Dr. Shotwell been forward thinking with this statute, but I'm very proud of the leadership that Senator Berger and Speaker Moore have shown with finding more solutions to this problem that we have across the United States. But thank you so much.
Thank you, Dr. Shotwell.
I stand before you today as a parent first and foremost. I have an elementary school student and a middle school student. I want every child, not only in Rockingham County, to be safe, but I want them to be safe everywhere. I was a high school principal when the Columbine happened, and that was our 9/11 in public schools. The age of innocence, of the open doors, of people just being able to come into the schools ended. And so now, you know, unfortunately there have been other shootings. For us here in Rockingham, meeting with the sheriff, I can't thank the leadership here, Senator Berger, Speaker Moore, because they have been very supportive of what we need to do in our schools. Safety is a multi-pronged issue that we deal with. The best defense we still have is if something doesn't seem right, tell somebody, because that, if you look back at some of these cases, there were pieces, there were signs, and that's what we're working at here. But really, to have volunteers in our schools who have prior experience, we have people here in this county who have grandchildren in many of our schools. And I think anytime we can have that coverage, it's gonna be great. Our kids see law enforcement in our schools, and they see them as assistants, you know, community help. They're not seen as just people who enforce the law. They see them as safety, and they see them as a friend. And I think that's another way, if we can have former police officers, deputies, military police to come into our schools and be able to provide that for us, it'll be a welcome change for us that we would definitely have here in Rockingham County. On behalf of my Board of Education, they're constantly asking me about safety, because we all want what's best for our kids. And I'm doing what they're asking me to do, and I appreciate their support, and we hope to be the model, not only for North Carolina, but maybe the nation, and able to make this program work. And again, I want to thank the leadership. Thank y'all very much for everything that you do for us.
I've got a couple of sheriffs that have traveled a little distance here, but I got one sheriff, Sheriff McDonald. He traveled all the way from the beautiful mountains, so up near, we call it Edneyville, up there where the Justice Academy is, up in Henderson County.
Yes, sir.
And we'd like to have you come up and say a few words, and I appreciate you making the trip today.
Sure thing.
Thank you.
Again, I'm not going to belabor what's been said already. I'm very proud to be a part of the folks from Raleigh, the other chiefs and sheriffs here. Again, as Sheriff Page said, this is one tool of many that we're all looking at. One of the things that I'm very gratified to see and would encourage across the state of North Carolina is that we continue to come together, leaving the differences out and really listening to the rank and file folks who can help us figure out what are the best avenues of approach to ensure the kind of school safety. I heard somebody say a few moments ago that North Carolina really could be a model, and I think it's going to be the citizens and the unity of law enforcement, school boards and administrations, and certainly our lawmakers are going to help that be successful. I want to say also, Sheriff Page, I certainly do appreciate you reviving this and looking at some of the things we can do to make it a little bit more substantial, a little bit more of a viable tool for school systems. Certainly, that's going to be up to the school administrators themselves in concert with their local sheriffs to decide what works best. But again, I think all the tools that we can have available certainly make us more likely to be successful in this endeavor. So thank you very much, sir.
And I'd like Sheriff Graves, would you like to come up and say a few words from Randolph County? Thank you. Yes, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. Robert Graves, Randolph County. Certainly proud to be here and in partnership with the legislature leaders and sheriffs to look at what we can do to keep our schools safe. That's our number one priority, is keeping our children safe. And I think we do a good job overall, but we can certainly, there's room for improvement, and this is a great tool to look at and study to see if it can help supplement the areas that we, resources doesn't provide the money or for additional SROs, for one thing maybe. But Randolph County, we have a lot of veterans in Randolph County, and I've already been in touch with a lot of them, calling in, talking to me, and retired officers. So I think it's a resource there that is untapped, that would have time and certainly an interest to come in and protect our children. I have a granddaughter in the public schools, and that's certainly precious to me. My daughter's a teacher, so I have a vested interest in that, along with all of our teachers and children in Randolph County. So glad to be a part of this, and look forward to moving forward as we work out the things that have to be put in place to make this law work. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sheriff. And this time, I'd like to reintroduce Senator Raven.
We want to say a few words here, and again, I apologize for not recognizing you in the beginning.
Thank you. Thank you very much, yes, and it's an honor to be here. I think one of the comments I'd like to make to start is that your Joint Legislative Emergency Management Oversight Committee has been looking at this problem specifically this year over the last 5 months, and we know that one leg of the stool is the action that's being taken locally right now, but there are other things that we can do to make our children more safe. I'd like to pass on the one comment. I think it's a sad time in our nation's history that we have to be at this point because of the way we have been divided by different forces. Having said that, be sure that the current legislation that's been discussed that gives rise to this program will be built on as a result of the committee's work, your committee. We have looked at technology, we've looked at technology for buildings, a whole gamut of things that come together. The safety at the school is an important adjunct to a total system of how we can keep our children safer. We will build on that legislation, and I can promise new legislation coming out, or recommendations for same from this committee's work. I commend you for taking the action. I think it's necessary, and we will do all I can. Anybody that wants to make input to the committee, please contact us, and we're still ongoing. We'll be winding up in the next couple of months. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator. I just want to add, and I will repeat this, is I support 100% putting trained, experienced former law enforcement officers or experienced law enforcement officers in our schools or military police, supervised by the chiefs, the sheriffs, or their designee, to protect our children. Yes, armed, to protect our children, and deter anybody who we might think about trying to create a problem or hurting our children or hurting our teachers or causing problems in our schools. Just now. At this time, if there's no one else that wants to speak, Kevin, what we're going to do is we're going to open up to any of our speakers that have been here today. You might want to ask them a question, and we'll set aside some time if you want to do an individual interview with any of our speakers here, if that'll be okay, if you'd like. So we'll be around for a little bit. So at this time, we're going to conclude our news conference. you have the opportunity to talk to them, speakers right here, if you want to ask a question, I'll take a few questions myself, and then I'm going to divert to my special guest who hears to speak.
Sheriff Page, even though this is a volunteer program, would it cost any money to implement this in the district or other districts?
I see some areas. Again, the bill was written. There's a few pieces, educational piece that we're working on with the Justice Academy to make sure it's in line with trainings and standards from the criminal justice side and from the sheriff's training standards. But I can see some costs for maybe some vests, maybe some weapons, ammunition for qualification, some basic identification jackets, maybe a uniform of some type to identify, because we want to quickly identify. We want a person to know that that volunteer is at that school, protecting that school, and that's his mission. So when you pull up, you see him. Or if an officer or a school resource is there, you see the car, and you see the veteran, and you see the police officer.
And where would that money come from? Would that be school board money?
At this time, undetermined. But, you know, we found the money, but right now we're trying to find a local solution. I always believe we get a lot of support from Washington, but we get a lot of support local. But I think from the state and local, I think we start fixing our problems at the local level first. Mm-hmm. And this is an effort. We've got the law on our side. Now we need to work with it. Yes, Charles.
Well, on social media right now, a lot of people responding favorably to you. We've got Nicole Bennett Scott saying, protect our babies. Yes, Sheriff Page. But I want to ask you from a liability standpoint.
Yes, sir.
If something goes wrong.
Yes, sir.
Well, how do you deal with that?
Well, you know, we as chiefs and we as sheriffs always have, we deal in the world with liabilities. But we do have some protections provided by the law on those liabilities. Actually, glad you asked that question, because before you came in, my insurance safety director for the county also advised that the insurance will cover our volunteers at school. So I'm sure, you know, if there's an injury or an accident, we've got coverage.
One more question.
A key word, when they're acting in good faith, following their duties, as is required by law, under the supervision of a chief, a sheriff, or their designee. Yes, sir.
Will you have enough to cover all the schools, enough volunteers?
I don't know that, but I think the faster we move forward on getting this program, this template set, or this model set, the quicker we can start trying to vet persons and advertising for volunteers. But, you know, they say build it and they will come, and I believe that.
And yes. Along those lines, what sort of vetting and training will go into this?
Well, I read some of that. There are some standards, firearm training. There's some standards set by the through the Justice Academy, working with the criminal justice standards, sheriff standards. That hasn't been fully developed. We're working on that now, working with the Justice Academy. But there are some state requirements that are in the law. But also, we as sheriffs and chiefs already have vetting programs in place for the employees. We want to make sure that we've got the best, even our volunteers, the best volunteers, protecting our children, our schools, and our teachers. Because again, at the end of the day, we're there to protect and serve. The kids should be there to learn, our children should be there to learn, and teachers should be there to teach. And I think that's the model that most people want to follow.
Yes. Sheriff Page, can you just please clarify? I remember last week, 2 weeks ago, the conversation had started. Now we're here today. Is it fair to say the ball is now rolling? We are currently working on it. Where do we stand right now?
Well, I got to take you back. I don't think it's the chief or a sheriff in his office. It's not worked on. For many years, they've been working on school safety initiatives, working with their principals, working with their school resource officers. They're already in the schools. So it's just a continuing process. But this is just another tool that we say, let's pull it up, let's fix it, let's set a template, and let's push it out across the state. And just like Dr. Schottwilliam said, this might be a model for the rest of the country. And again, it's a volunteer model, and we've got a lot of good volunteers out there who want to give back.
Yes, Sheriff.
Yes, ma'am, go ahead.
Sheriff Page, there's been a lot of conversation nationally about the possibility of arming teachers in our classrooms. Do you have any thoughts on that? And second of all, do you think this would be a more viable option?
I think this is a great option. I think the full-time school resource officers, again, I've always said this, trained, proficient, experienced officers working in schools, whether it be volunteers or full-time school resource officers. Now, I'm a big supporter of the carry conceal process in Rockingham County. I've got nearly 7,012 carry conceal permittees. That's about 8% of the population. I'd like to get about 10%, but that's private concealed carry under the law permitted. But in the schools, that's a decision that the school boards and the school representatives and those leaders will have to make those decisions. But I would think, and I don't want to totally speak for the teachers, but I think there's a lot of teachers who probably say, I'd like the officers to the protection part, protecting, sending a deterrence to other factors. Somebody might try to hurt our children, and then let us teach our kids so they have an environment to teach and the kids have a safe environment to learn. I think that's the model that most people and most parents expect. Yes, Charles.
So since we got the representatives from Raleigh here,
will y'all be watching this program and supporting it? I mean, what kind of...
Charles, let me step in and ask the question.
Will you guys be supporting him and watching the program and trying to help him?
I don't think there's any question. That's the reason we're here today, is because the sheriff contacted us, indicated what he was moving forward with, pointed out the law that both of us voted for a couple of years ago, and I think it's the right step. It's probably not the final step, but it's something that needs to be done. And actually, I want to commend former Representative Brian Holloway, because he is the one that actually introduced and moved the bill in the legislature in 2013.
Why do you think it's so long for us to take action?
You know, I don't know that it's important to talk too much about that. I think the fact is, and the important thing is, that action is being taken at this point, and what you have is cooperation between law enforcement and school administrators for the purpose of protecting our kids, and I think that's the important thing as far as this is concerned.
I have one more question. As far as the law itself, why include sort of these stipulations in terms of having former law enforcement and former military policing in that?
It would be my thought that you want to make sure that if you have someone on school grounds authorized to have a weapon, that person should be fully qualified, fully trained. And this law pretty much makes those volunteers have to go through what is tantamount to the same training that a police officer would have to have in order to be a school resource officer. So I think that's important.
It's also worth noting that the language that was used in this eligibility was developed in consultation with law enforcement. So we as legislators rely very heavily on what folks in education, law enforcement suggest. So when this bill was done, when this language was developed, we want to make sure that the individuals who were there were fully qualified. For example, when it comes to the military, former military, they had to have also been honorably discharged as well. Mm-hmm.
And I did want to add that when a person is working that capacity as a volunteer school safety resource officer, they have full arrest powers while they're operating in that capacity. But again, I feel good that the person has prior experience as a law enforcement officer, because I know what to expect. I've worked with law enforcement officers, again, for more than 30 years, whether it be police department or sheriff's office. But the good thing is, the sheriffs and the chiefs, not just the sheriffs and the chiefs across North Carolina, had the ability to pull upon a tool out of that toolbox. And because we're work in progress, we just want to continue doing better. And this is a step in the right direction. And I think that the chiefs and the sheriffs across North Carolina will see that. And let me tell you that some schools, the chiefs may have resource officers at every school, and they may not want to push out the volunteer program. But in my county, I have two resource officers at the elementary school covering six schools. So that's three apiece. They can't be in six schools at the same time. I want more dedicated presence there to deter a violent act that somebody might want to perpetrate on one of our schools.
Lastly,
I don't want to preempt any of the outcomes of what our committee process is going to produce, but I'd like to comment on this just a little bit. Number one, the issue came up of the concealed carry permit. I don't want to offend anybody, but I've taken that training. I've also been in the chaos of combat, and I will tell you that that training is insufficient for the kind of thing that we're talking about. I will discuss that with anybody privately that wants to talk about it. That's a personal opinion, but one of the things that the committee has found throughout the discussions that we've had, vetting, training, selecting the right people are absolutely essential in anyone that goes to walk into a school or any place, any other public building, with the intent of protecting the population. Thank you.
Okay, at this time we're going to conclude our news conference, unless anybody has anything they want to say. If you would like to talk to any of the persons that are here, they'll stay. You can feel free to interview. I'm just going to step to the side. So if not, y'all follow me.